Are we there yet?
No.
Are we there yet?
No.
Are we there yet?
No!
Are we there yet?
Yes.
Okay.
So the Polaris Galaxy. Tachyon owns all of it?
Nice puberty yep. there.
Well, McDonald's owns half.
The one Kragmite they didn't vaporize comes back to oppress the galaxy.
Who is they?
Who? Are you kidding me?
Drive! Drive!
Vaporized hands on the wheel!
10 o'clock and 2 o'clock!
Nothing but an empty hunk of dirt.
Rock! All hail the Lombaxes! All saviors of the universe!
Hey, I'm a Lombaxus.
Attention, transport vessel. A bioscan reveals a Lombax life form aboard your ship. Stand by for immediate disintegration.
Rock! Get your Lombax! Nothing but trouble! Nothing but trouble!
Sir, if you jettison the excess cargo,
I'll shoot you.
Increase your speed and evade capture.
I couldn't agree more.
This isn't what I meant at all!
Motherfucker!
Okay, so this is another one of those six axis dodgy things, and I actually do get hit twice. But
that is the last time we trust Robert Muldoon.
Well, no it isn't.
He's just complete asshole ever since he turned into a velociraptor.
Well, yeah.
What are you dodging?
I'm dodging missiles.
They're very slow missiles.
Yes, I got hit twice, and that was the only two times I'll get hit by those.
Why did they leave a purple trail?
Because science fiction. Another thing I forgot to mention about the shops is that they actually completely heal you when you use them, and I accidentally went back into that shop. I don't think I bought anything there. I might have upgraded some weapons, though.
Oh, we're back to the fish robots.
Yes. It will...
I miss the fish robots.
Yes.
They're not very fast.
No, they're not. They're very slow, very clunky. They are basically there for you to slaughter them. And here, I almost start to get the Raritanium, then I'm like, wait a minute. I didn't break that double Raritanium chest yet. So I kill pretty much every fish on my way there.
And now you're gonna get the chest.
Yes.
Hooray!
You'll notice me using Plasma Beasts a lot in this video, mainly because I'm trying to get them to level 5 as soon as possible, because they become even better at level 5. So,
these fish have riot shields.
Yes. Riot shields usually block most weaponry. For the most part, grenades can hurt them really well, and we're about to get a weapon that will hurt them even better than grenades. Right after we kill this tank.
It seems like an impractical design for a tank. Hooray!
Hooray! Yeah, they level up really fast, the Plasma Beasts. I have no idea why. I'm not complaining at all. But they're going to be the first weapon that we get up to level 5, and I think it's either next video or the video after that one.
Can you get the armor yet?
No. The armor is like 30,000. I think that is the next thing I buy, though.
Yay!
Okay, this is the Shock Ravager. It's a whip. It's an electric
the
whip.
Ravager uses electrical current to neutralize shielded
enemies. Alright.
And like that lady just said, it's really good at getting past shielded enemies. And just for tutorial purposes, the game spawns some shielded enemies for us, this Shock Ravage.
How convenient.
Yes! Also, something I neglected to mention, you can quickly switch between the last two weapons that you've used by just tapping the triangle button rather than pushing and holding it to bring up the wheel. So that's nice if you've got two weapons on standby that you use quite a bit.
Oh hey, it's that guy.
Yeah.
I don't remember his name, and I don't really care.
Percival.
Percival.
No, that's his actual name.
Percival.
Yeah, Percy and us aren't the best of friends.
Droffids. What is Droffids?
The Droffids are the fish dudes in the robot suits.
Oh, okay. I just called them useless assholes.
Yeah. Plasma beasts absolutely rape everything. I will never not love these things. And just in case you're wondering, the deal with the city is that it's like, I'm pretty sure it's the central base of operations for Percy here.
Percival.
Oh, and I'm meant to mention, thanks to Nidoking?
Cloaking!
Yes, thanks to Nidoking for telling me that the wrench is the thing that the bolts are, that your bolts are actually attracted to. So throwing the bolts gets you...
You mean the wrench?
Yes, the wrench is the thing that the bolts are attracted to. So...
Throwing the wrench attracts the bolts to it. It's much easier to pick them all up.
Yes.
I thought you've played this game before.
I've been playing the series since 2002 and I didn't know that. Cut me some slack.
No.
You're right, because I was absolutely slack.
Is he blowing up his own city now?
No. No, not yet. I don't think he really blows it up, I just think he shoves a lot of guys at you.
And you know what? It would actually be really easy to defeat you if they just sent some guy out to clean up all these crates.
Yeah. And, like, never, ever give me any money. Oh, okay, so... I mentioned last video how every weapon has a special upgrade you can get through Raritanium. I just bought the Combustor's special upgrade. Basically, when the fireballs land on the ground, they keep burning for a short amount of time, so whoever's standing in that area will continually take damage.
That's kind of not useless.
Kind of not useless. It makes this shot, combustor, less useless. It's still useless, but...
Just throw the wrench at them.
I didn't know that. Jesus. I'll start throwing the wrench at them later.
You're a disappointment.
I am a disappointment. I'm terrible at this game.
Yeah, you're like... really low on health now. Use a little flippy move.
A little flippy... oh yeah, that little flippy move.
Christ. I'm better at this game than you and I'm not the one playing it.
Whatever, I don't die. And even if I did, I'd edit it out so it looks like I didn't die.
So you're terrible and you're a liar.
If I die, I'll point it out.
He's all exhausted. You're such a terrible person.
I am. But on the plus side, I'm about to gain enough experience to get another bout of health, and when that happens, you automatically regain all the health that you've lost. So, that'll be a thing that happens.
What did he say there?
Anybody who... does not aid in catching the Lombax, or no, anybody who lets the Lombax through their sector will be tried as a conspirator and executed.
You're gonna die. You're just gonna edit it out.
No, I swear I don't die. Besides, I don't know how to do editing that seamless yet. And look, we get
maybe
more goo. We get more goo to play around with, and I play around with it.
Woohoo goo.
Well, you'll actually see that the goo will come in handy a little bit later, but for right now, it's just for me to be lazy with jumping.
You said that 3 times.
Yeah, he repeats
Shut
stuff
the
a
hell
lot.
Up, Ursel.
He repeats stuff a lot in this stage. He only says one thing per set area that you're in. It gets really annoying really fast. The first time is funny, the second time is amusing, the third time you're just like, SHUT UP! Okay, and I didn't know it until... earlier today, actually, you can get a skill point by using the goo to make a level 3 cube and jump over the gap instead of activating the bridge.
You're useless.
I didn't know that till today. I was looking through the book and I saw it. See, look, I didn't die.
I still think you're gonna die.
No, that doesn't happen till next video.
And is it in an amusing way?
Yes.
I'm looking forward to it then.
See, look, I could just totally high jump those, but I decided to use goo instead. I have goo.
You're the laziest man in the universe.
I have goo. I'm going to use it, goddammit.
And they could sell this in the USA easily. Just market it to lazy fat people. Why walk when you can bounce your way around town?
It sounds like something Nerf would sell.
I would buy them.
I would.
But I would probably be using it less to get around and more of blocking hallways.
Okay, and here you can go down to the next area, but there's some more crates over there, and I activated that crate down below by flying over it. I'm still not exactly sure how that happened.
How are they placing these in the first place? I mean, they're that sensitive that they're... You have to arm them and then run like hell.
Yeah.
Maybe they're remotely armed or something.
Maybe.
I don't know.
Video games.
Floating crates and video games. This is us arguing about the logistics of these.
And here I am, not knowing about throwing the wrench, being useful, and completely going to these one by one and destroying them all.
Exciting gameplay! Watch this asshole destroy crates for an hour. Hi, Percival.
Okay, well, I'll explain after the cutscene. We get something new here.
Ratchet, those creatures are telling us to go inside that building.
What creatures?
Creatures? What creatures?
I said that.
Did you get your
Stop stealing my jokes.
They stole this from Flintstones, I swear.
Hi, how you doing? Like to come to a party? Hey, look.
Plank. Have you been modifying yourself in private?
Absolutely.
Only a little.
And I do not care much for your tone.
Okay, so these are robo wings. You can use them to fly around. This sounds like fun.
Really?
Until you realize the flying around
you can
is with six
the
axes.
Wings to fly.
You can they are controlled
with
six axes.
Fascinating. Tell me more.
They're controlled.
What can I do in water? Can I swim in water?
If you would let me.
Can I walk on the ground?
Shut up! Yeah. Fortunately, this is much better 6-axis than most 6-axis stuff, so you can kinda control yourself, but it still looks like I'm a little drunk when I'm doing this.
Are we getting, like, really close to that thing, or is it just huge? Oh, it's huge.
They're fair size. They're fair
Sony
size.
Are freaky
okay,
ass things.
There's a couple hidden stuff that you can get by flying around, but I decide to not do that. I'll do that in a later video.
Destroy that one exploding crate.
Yes, there are supposed to be other crates there. I don't know why the game didn't spawn them. Okay, and speaking of water, watch me flail about trying to remember how the water mechanics work. There we go.
Attention citizens, you can't get the hall of knowledge without authorization.
Basically, you can go up and down by pushing square and triangle, or square and X, excuse me, and you can push R1 to make Clank activate his little jets, so that way you can swim faster. There's no reason not to swim faster, because you always have pretty good maneuverability underwater.
So, what is this building for?
This is the Hall of Knowledge, and it is forbidden to be... in here. Basically,
why is the Hall of Knowledge full of water? the water knowledge? If we drink it, will we learn stuff?
I wish. No, it's just a puzzle thing.
Books, now in water form.
Attention, citizen. The knowledge in this hall is protected by traps and puzzles, so deviously complex that they will fuse your neural pathway should you even attempt them. For your own safety, turn back.
I really like that woman.
Oh, sec. This game turned into a portal very briefly.
Yeah, the swimming in this game isn't too bad, unlike most 3D games.
You appear to be more clever than we anticipated.
Mainly because you go pretty fast and you have unlimited air, so.
Spare yourself the abject humiliation of failing and turn back now.
The little narrator for this hall of knowledge is really reminding me of GLaDOS.
Yeah! I know, like, I know this game was made before Portal came out, but we're around the same time, I think, so.
It's kind of freaking me out.
Okay, and here, we gotta use this.
Shut up, I'm listening to GLaDOS.
The knowledge contained in this hall has been classified as a threat to the Empire. Any attempt to enter the Imperial map room will result in a very painful...
Alright, boring, you can talk.
Okay, basically we use that to bring these jellyfish up, and if you use your goo on... one of the jellyfish over here, you get a special surprise.
It's a goo block on a guild jellyfish, hooray!
Yep, it's a gold bolt! And believe it or not, I could not get that gold bolt for forever. I couldn't understand how you were supposed to get it, and then I was like, oh right, goo!
Are you retarded? Like, literally retarded?
Maybe, a little bit.
That explains so much.
It really does.
Also, like that.
Well, you can't exactly jump. You have to wait till you're hanging, otherwise you just do a wall jump. And I completely ignore that rare titanium chest because I thought you could just go it. I thought you walked for a little while before dropping down a hole.
This is giving more and more fuel for my retarded theory.
Well, yes. And here, you just need to fight until all the enemies are dead and then the level ends.
Hooray!
It was a pretty short one.
I like that guy just hanging out in the window. Like, hey guys, can I come in?
I'm too big! Even though he's not too big, he could totally fit through that window if he sucked in his gut.
He's a fish in a robot suit. He has no gut. I like the music here.
The music for this entire game is pretty good.
So why did we come here again?
Because we're stupid.
Planet Fastone.
You didn't exactly come here. You were sort of dropped off.
Well, according to the database, it is a Lombax planet.
Download the coordinates. We'll take the escape pod.
But Ratchet, the database...
Why is there an escape pod in a building?
Come on!
Deus Ex Machina.